Did you just sneeze? If you did, bless you. Do you know what I think is weird? See, when you meet someone the first time, you don't really know them, and they stand way too close like that. I mean, you know, in real life, they're better lit. Hi, really nice to meet you. So, this weekend, I didn't watch the golf. But that won't stop me talking about it, because, you know, I'm a guy on TV. I don't need to know what I'm talking about. You see people on TV? Did anyone on TV know what they're talking about? Come on. Well, let me just say, in the fullness of time, oh, shut up. Anyway, I didn't watch it, but I think a lot of people were probably watching this weekend to see Tiger Woods because he was getting back to the golf. And I'm thinking, what are you waiting for him to do? Is his golf going to be any different? Are you watching his pants or something? And Tiger's teeing up for the shot. What are they expecting? Is he going to start humping the ball or something like that? It seems so odd to me. He's like, oh, we're watching Tiger now. Golf suddenly sexy. Why? I'm pretty sure golf is pretty much what it's always been. You get there, you hit that over there. If it goes in first, you win. But guess what happened this weekend? Well, not this weekend. Monday, which is today. Actually, it is. So today, I get an email from... So today I got, the idea of Grandpa gets an email, that's funny. What's that, Jeff? I get emails, right, Jeff?
What you talking about with this guy?
Anyway, I get this email, right? And it's, because I won the Peabody Award, I'm very excited about it. Please, thanks, right. And then I got it. I got the Peabody Award for interviewing Archbishop Desmond Tutu. And Father Tutu heard about this in South Africa, so he sent an email saying congratulations. It was very gracious. And, but he, you know how he signs his emails? Arch. For Archbishop. Isn't that adorable? And I was thinking, you can't get cooler than Archbishop Desmond Tutu. But apparently you can, by email. That's pretty cool, isn't it? Calling yourself... What do I call my... You give yourself your title and your email, but you short... I'll be just like, do. Short for douche. We'll be right back, everybody.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Sponsored by Subway Restaurants. Subway now has breakfast. Build your better breakfast only at Subway.
Good, you're on the way to free chicken. Sit down. I always promise the audience free chicken if they're enthusiastic. I promise them chicken. I never give them chicken. Why? Because I'm a bitch. I'm a chicken promising bitch. But you like that, don't you? Promise me more chicken, mistress. I will. That's a great day for America, everybody, isn't it? It is a great day for Conan O'Brien. It was announced today that Conan has a new talk show on TBS. And a lot of people have been saying, Craig, how will this affect your show? And I'm like, it will not. People who watch this show cannot afford basic cable, or they would not be on the show. I'm not worried at all. And not only am I not worried, I don't care. And also, there are rumors today, and I hope they're true, that Elizabeth Taylor is getting married for the 9th time. Isn't that lovely? I think it's great. One more, and she qualifies for a free chicken sandwich at Quiznos. And there's nothing like the promise of free chicken to get people motivated. Free chicken? I'll do it. Now, although it's a great day for America, it is a sad day for pigs. Oh, laugh if you like, but it's sad. Laugh if you like chicken, I should say. No, pigs are lovely, very intelligent animals. I love pigs, but unfortunately, of course, for them, they are delicious. And today... today, KFC restaurants have unveiled something called the Double Down, and it's two... Yeah. It's a gamble, all right. It's two slabs of fried chicken with bacon in the middle. Why not? We're all getting free in health insurance. Let's go nuts. What the hell? Bacon, chicken, bacon. Today we eat bacon. Tomorrow we get our arteries unclogged for free. This new sandwich, it's awesome. It's basically a three-way between two chickens and a pig. I think there's a website for that, actually. Porky'sDream.com. Dude, bacon, I can't believe I'm saying this. Bacon is now a trendy foodstuff. Bacon, it's not just in fast food. If you go to any high-end restaurant in Hollywood, which I don't, but if you do, they got bacon all over the menu. You open the menu, bacon falls out in your lap. If you want to tip your waiter, you just stuff bacon in his pants. There you go, Toots, get yourself something nice. It's true. Bacon is the new cocaine. People in bathrooms chopping up lines of pork. Lindsay Lohan's been arrested with someone else's bacon strips in her pants. Hey, it's a weak premise, but I'm enthusiastic about it. No, foodies are saying that America's in the middle of a bacon revolution. Foodies, by the way, are people who love food and love talking about food. They're like Trekkies, but even fatter. What, I'm lying? For a long time, bacon was uncool. Now it's cool. But bacon is extremely high in salt and saturated fat, and it goes straight to my ass. There's only one kind of bacon that doesn't go straight to my ass, and that is Kevin Bacon. And I wish he would. I don't know why I'm saying that. Everybody loves bacon, though, even vegetarians. Come on, admit it, vegetarians, you love bacon. Paul McCartney, the most famous vegetarian in the world, one of them. Anyway, he's always saying he won't eat meat, and then there was a recent paparazzi photograph of him enjoying one of those Double Down sandwiches I'm talking about. Do we have a picture of that there? There you go. Wait, now wait. It's been a while, yeah. Can I see that picture again? Look, now look. It looks like Sir Paul's being fed his Double Down sandwich by some sort of waxy midget. There you go, Sir Paul! There's your chicken thing. I love bacon, no, all types of bacon. I particularly enjoy Sir Francis Bacon, the English... Sir Francis Bacon, the 17th century English philosopher. You know who I'm talking about. He was also a scientist and a politician. Do we have a picture of Sir Francis Bacon? There he is, there. Look at that. That's how we used to roll in the 17th century, kids. You think you're cool now? Look at that, that's cool. That's what they called back then, big pimping. Francis Bacon, of course, invented bacon. Yeah, why why not? That's right. He invented bacon because before him in the 17th century, pigs were kept as pets. And what happened was that his pet pig fell into the fire, and Sir Francis Bacon's hands were broken at the time, so he tried to save his pig using his mouth. So the pig's in the fire going, help me, I'm burning! And he's like, I'll get you out there, Corky! And he'd, And then he went, oh, delicious. That might be true. A lot of people think that Sir Francis Bacon was the real author of Shakespeare's plays because they say that Shakespeare wasn't educated enough to have written them. But I don't think Francis Bacon could have written Shakespeare's plays. He didn't have the time. He was because he was a musician, he had to save his pig from the fire, and he was in a band. He had the Bacon Brothers band. Do we have a, do we have a picture of Sir Francis Bacon with his band? There he is. Man, that was a lot of talking for a crap photograph, wasn't it? All right, Jeff.
Yeah, babe.
Hey, you know, a few months ago, I did a stand-up tour in Canada, right? And every town I went to, you know, all the Canadians say to you, have you tried our bacon, eh? And because they're famous for Canadian bacon. But here's the strange thing. I was all over Canada. I never saw one single pig. Which leads me to believe Canadian bacon is made of people. Canadian people. You could feed a family of four for a month on William Shatner alone. I'm kidding. Canadian bacon is just really ham. So is William Shatner, actually. All right, it's commercial break time, isn't it? Do KFC have a commercial? What do you think, Jeff? You fond of the bacon?
Yum, yum, bacon!
Can't believe you can say bacon. That's awesome.
Yeah, babe.
I'm sick of that skeleton, I'm telling you.
What you talking about with this guy?
Whoa! All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back.
Spanish word of the day. Today's word is tocino. Tocino.
And basically, it's welcome back, everybody. Sorry, I was just trying to explain to the audience using puppets what this new delicacy will be like, but unfortunately, I only have one chicken and two pigs. So I'm trying to explain how the sandwich will appear. It'll be like this, but in reverse. So in the middle. They'll be like that. Doesn't that look tasty? Yeah. Jeff, what will we do now?
Boring.
Yes.
Tweets and emails,
yeah, tweets and emails, yeah, all right. Tweets and emails. Well, let's try that then, Jeff. Wonder if Conan needs a new sidekick for this TV last night. All right, play the jingle. Let's get on with it.
Twitter. Tweeting. Ephemeral. Fleeting. Flugelweb. Face code. Twit zone. Ask mode.
Und also E-Mails!
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back from the jingle. Wasn't that awesome? all right, let's see. We got a... This is an email. Yeah, it's an email. You can tell because it's been edited. It's been... What the FBI get onto it? All right. This is from Jessica in Sacramento in California. She says, Craig, I want to break up with my boyfriend, but I still want to sleep with him. How do I make this happen? Just tell him. He'll be good with it. So let me get this straight. I don't have to cuddle you or meet you at places. I just have to have sex with you? Yeah. All right, then. Yeah, I think you'll be all right. This is from Ari in Manila in the Philippines. Wow. I didn't know CBS went to the Philippines. Oh, on the Tweety machine. On the face tube, eh? All right, Ari says, Craig, the other night you said you experienced phantom vibration syndrome. I did, when you feel your cell phone buzzing on your leg and you don't even have your cell phone with you. I'm having it right now. The other night is, I sometimes hear my cell phone ringing when really it isn't. What is this called? This is called the delirium tremens. And it is a result of, or the DTs for sure. It's probably a hallucination of some sort. You'll be fine. This is from Veronica in Oakville in Ontario. The one in Canada or the one in Canada? Oh, I know where it is. It's just outside of Toronto. Although in Toronto, if you live in Toronto, they don't say they're from Toronto. They say Toronto. Where are you from? Toronto. Want some bacon? Made of people? I look forward to your letters. Veronica, I'm going to Toronto soon. That'll be good. They'll be all mad at me. Maybe I should postpone my visit. Veronica says, Dear Craig, I used to want to be a doctor, but now I want to be an actress. Same thing. Can I still be smart and be an actress too? Yes, of course. They don't ask you to be stupid. You know, it's not like you... No, they don't. No, that's not fair. No, there's plenty of smart actresses. It's just that you can't... Look, you can't be a doctor and be stupid. You can't. But you can be an actress and be stupid. But you can also be an actress and be smart. But what will happen is you will get bored. But that's okay. But you'll find something else to do. You know, that's why so many... Angelina Jolie, for example, an actress, right? She gets bored, though, so she helps other people and, you know, and does things, adopts children, has other interests. You've got to have other interests. There you go. I look forward to your letters. All right, here's a Tweety. This is... you can tell it's a Tweety because there's an eagle on it. Apparently eagles tweet. Craig, I am 20 and I had white hair since I was 12. I am thinking about just dyeing my hair white instead of black. Am I crazy? Oh, maybe this is a picture of him then. No, you want to keep that white hair? That looks great. Nothing worse than an eagle with dyed black hair. You look stupid. All right, I know we're out of time. I'll just do one more. All right, this is not necessary for me to read. Neither is this. This is from Colleen in Bowie in Maryland, or Bowie in Maryland. I'm not quite sure. Anyway, this is probably Colleen here. My ex-husband wants to come over and watch hockey. Do you think he's coming on to me? Depends. Did you leave him with a TV? Because if you took that as well, it might be just to watch hockey. All right, we have to take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Show where everything's gone Monday crazy. You can by the way, if you want to see this episode of the show, it'll be on the CBS website tomorrow. Maybe. Because what we believe here in CBS is that once the show goes out, then you'll want to go and see it on a website after you've seen it. As opposed to, oh, I know the other guys, that what they're doing, putting up their clips of their show before the show airs. That's not how we do things at the Tiffany Network. Oh, no, 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 sir. No, we don't want you seeing clips of the show before it goes out. We want you seeing clips of the show after it goes out. Imagine if a movie were being released. You would say, oh, I haven't seen any clips of the movie. No, they don't release the clips of the movie until after people have gone to see the movie. Please, everyone, please. We'll have to cut that out and put that on the website. But my first guest tonight is on a fantastic television show. It really is a very good show. It's called Project Runway. It's Thursdays on the Lifetime Network. Take a look at this.
Well, that was fun.
I got something special in mind for you.
You do? What is it?
Papa Gunn's on the trap.
The Hendersons are trying to kill me.
Dude, I did it.
Yeah.
I got Tim to jump on our trampoline and to see him interact with my kids. Man, it's just awesome.
Please welcome the very lovely my friend Tim Gunn, everybody. Tim Gunn.
It's
Tim, you look immaculate.
You.
It's just lovely.
I have to do it for you because you look immaculate yourself.
Oh, stop now. Look at me. I'm in Bob Barker's old suit.
Well, I have to tell you something about Jeff.
Jeff Peterson, the skeleton
robot? Jeff Peterson. He has the same affliction as the models during Fashion Week. I wouldn't be at all surprised to see him on the runway.
Hey, don't give him any ideas. Have you met Tim Gunn, Jeff?
Hi. How are you?
Yeah, wow. Yeah, I didn't know you'd know you knew each other. He's very excited. I've never seen him.
Tim Gunn, Mike, Jeff, Horny.
All right, that's enough. I'm terribly sorry about that. How are you? The Project Runway is awesome this season.
Thank you.
I was worried last season, I'm going to be honest with you.
You have a lot of company.
Because when it was set in Los Angeles, I was like, it doesn't work. We don't care about clothes in L.A. But it's back. Well, we don't. We're just a bunch of strippers. But in New York, it's back where it belongs.
We're back home.
Yeah.
We're back home. And we're showing the audience that with our new production company, Buna Murray, and with our new network, Lifetime, we can make it work.
You've made that make it work thing. That's kind of like, you're probably a billionaire off of that now, aren't you?
No.
Yeah. So, listen, how do you, when I talk to you, I'm always impressed at how genial and how polite and how lovely you are. And you're not just like that on camera, like a lot of the douchebags we get here. You're actually really nice. And
thank you.
How do you manage to do that in the world of fashion? Because not everyone subscribes to your mode of behavior.
Well, Craig, my mode of operating in the world is take the high road. So whenever I see bad behavior abounding, and I see a lot of it, rise above it. Don't go down to that level. Simply don't. And in the fashion industry, there's a lot of bad behavior.
Yeah, well, yeah. But
it's true.
But how do you specifically rise above it? Like, if you feel very angry, if someone's being very, very rude to you, like when someone's being mean or saying something horrible to you.
It happened to me recently.
Did it really?
Yes.
Was it Michael Kors? I always suspected it would be Michael Kors.
Michael's a lovely guy.
Is he?
He really is.
I'm
He's a lovely
of him.
Guy.
I quite like him to be a guest on the show because he's clearly a great artist. But
indeed.
I'm a little worried that he would be bitchy to me.
Michael is really one of the sweethearts. He truly is, which is why we have him on the show. I mean,
he's
very positive and his criticism is very thoughtful and considerate, usually.
He's very honest. Well, who was it that was mean to you recently, though? It wasn't Michael Kors then?
You know,
or you can't say?
Well, I can say, I won't name names because you wouldn't know who this person is, but I offer myself up for charity auctions frequently, and it's generally a lunch, because anything to support good causes.
Right.
And occasionally, I will have lunch with a true nutcase.
Yeah.
I mean, someone who just is abhorrent. And this one particular person, this man asked me about my suits. And I said, because he shared with me that he didn't believe in wearing suits that cost less than $4,000 or $5,000.
Well, right there you go. Tootsie fruits. Right there.
And he said to me, I said, well, I believe in shopping on a budget.
Right.
And he said, I can tell because I can smell the cheapness of that suit from here, he said. And
it's, it sounds like Hannibal
Lecter. Well, you know something?
Yeah.
You're right. He was a lot like Hannibal Lecter.
Yeah.
He should have been in a Hannibal Lecter suit. Yes, exactly. So
yeah,
it's at moments like that when I want to just get up and leave the lunch, but I thought, well, he's paid for me. Maybe he thinks he's paid to insult me.
Yeah.
And I then just have a kind of out-of-body experience and step away from it and figure, forgive me, he's crazy.
Yeah.
So
wait a minute. You rent yourself out for charity to actually have lunch with people so that he gives money to the charity.
Yeah, exactly.
Tim, that's something of a call girl.
Well, it's a lunch in a public place with lots of people around, no tablecloths.
Oh, okay. All right, well, as long as you feel comfortable. But it's that whole, I take myself out of body and everything, I'm thinking, wait a minute.
No, it happens infrequently. Usually
right.
People couldn't be lovelier, couldn't be nicer. We have a great time, and it's good for the cause.
Yeah, I suppose. Now, when you see, fashion is such an eclectic thing to say. There's so many different styles and different
Indeed.
Looks. What draws you to a, women's clothes in particular seem to be more eclectic than men's. I mean, you
they
just
are.
Go,
I mean,
you
know, there's not a single day I don't thank my lucky stars that I'm a guy. It's so much easier for us.
Yeah, well, yeah, it's, I don't think that every day. Sometimes I see a dress and go, curses. Why can't I? Why?
Well, Craig,
and then I do.
I was just going to say, you could.
I know. No, but when you look at women's fashion, is there anything, any particular style that you're drawn to or anything that you find abhorrent, anything that, what pulls you in?
Well, I'm always looking for clothes that have a spirit of innovation,
right,
yet don't go the way of Ringling Brothers, aren't clown clothes.
Right.
And clothes that
you don't like clowns then, huh?
But you know something, to be really honest with you, I'm clown phobic.
Really?
I'm terrified by them.
Quite a few people don't like clowns.
And I had a horrible circus experience as a child. I mean,
do
really
tell, what happened?
Well, they wheeled a huge gorilla in a cage into the middle of the center ring.
Yes.
And the gorilla broke out and came.
Are you sure this wasn't a movie?
No, no, no.
All right.
Broke out and went running through the audience, throwing people's popcorn in the air and drinks. And I was so terrified. I was with my father and my sister. I was so terrified. My screams were mute. And I didn't realize it was a guy in a gorilla suit.
Oh!
You know? I didn't realize that. So every time I even see an ad for a circus.
I'm sorry, this is terribly sad.
It was a really good gorilla suit.
Yeah, it would have to be an awesome gorilla
it
suit.
Was.
Now, what age were you when this happened?
I must have been 5 or 6.
Oh, well, yeah. It might not have been that good a gorilla suit then.
And I still break out.
I can see it having
sweat.
An effect on you now. As you're talking, I'm thinking, well, I'm really glad we cancelled the gorilla. Because I thought it would be hilarious, but now I can
not hilarious at all.
Don't bring the gorilla at all. So you don't like clown clothing then, or anyone wearing lots of furry pants?
Not a good look.
No, okay. So, but what does draw you in? What is the classic woman's evening wear, for example?
Well, a classic Grecian column. Classical draping.
What, that's like a drapey thing with one shoulder?
Well, it could be one shoulder, not necessarily, could be strapless. But for me, the simpler the clothes, the more impact they have, generally
right.
speaking, because when you have tons of frills and flourishes and flounces, it begins to just look ridiculous.
Well, you know what I think is interesting as well? A lot of times when they're showing clothes, the girls, as you pointed out, look a bit like Jeff. They're very thin.
Sorry, Jeff.
Nothing wrong with that, Jeff. But yeah, all right. But what happens is that clothes that look very good on people who are very thin may not look that good on someone who looks like a human. You know, there's someone who's a little.
Well, that is certainly the case, and what is also the case is when it comes to realistic sizes, the size and shape women really are, it's very important that a design be reconceived. It's not a matter of sizing up that look on the 15-year-old who's 6'5 on the runway. It's you can't just size it up. You really have to reconceive it. And I have to say, from my own experience, anyone can look fantastic. It's a matter of silhouette, proportion, and fit. I mean, I'm always saying to women who say, I couldn't possibly look good, look at me. I say, look at the opera divas.
Yes, that's right.
They look great.
They're big, enormous, comfortable ladies.
Well, and they're polished and they're sophisticated.
Yes, absolutely.
And elegant.
But what? When did that become a fashion on the runway? Why is it so important to drape clothes on very thin people? If your customers aren't.
It confounds me, I have to say. And Diane von Furstenberg, the president of the Council of Fashion Designers of America.
She's very talented as well. She makes great clothes.
She's vowed to put an end to this.
Right.
And she's campaigning. And in her role as president of the CFDA, she can do just that. And I heard recently that Michael Kors said he's not doing it anymore.
More power to them. I hope they do that. Yeah. I think it sends out a bad message. In fact, I'm going to replace Jeff with someone who's fatter.
Well, you know, somebody.
That's right, Jeff.
So many of these girls aren't through puberty. I mean, they're not fully developed. It's crazy.
It's madness.
What happens next? Is going to be an 8-year-old?
No.
That you put on stilts? I don't know.
No.
It's too much like the circus.
That's right. Tim, we're out of time. It's always lovely to see you, and well done on a fantastic season of Project Runway.
Thank you so
this time.
Much,
Tim Gunn, everybody. We'll be right back. Right there, my next guest has written a book. Do you hate it when you meet strangers and they hold books really close to you like that? She's written a book. It's called Queen of Your Own Life. It's in stores now. Please welcome my friend Kathy Kinney, everybody. Kathy Kinney. Kathy, you look well. You look adorable. I like your top.
Thank you.
And your bottom.
Here's what happened.
What?
Ready? I'm coming into the building, and a gentleman holds the door for me, and I say thank you, and he says, I love your music. And I thought, what is he talking about? And then I realized he thought I was Susan Boyle.
How did you go straight to Susan Boyle? He could have thought anything.
Madonna?
Maybe Madonna. I don't know. You don't need to go to Susan Boyle.
Gwen Stefani. Oh, who do you think? Who do you think? Be honest, Jeff.
Jeff, who do you think?
That got me right on the funny bone, yeah!
Stupid idea, but I'm married to it now. You know, what can you do? Hey, right, tell me about your book. Queen of Your Life.
Yes.
Hey, oh, wow, look. Cindy Ratzlaff is on the back, too.
That's right. She wrote the book with me.
Oh, your friend Cindy Ratzlaff. I've met Cindy.
With Susan Boyle.
Yeah. Cindy and Susan, own your life and win your show business dreams.
Here's what happened.
What is it?
I was surfing the net, and I found out that
did
now...
Did you go to porkysdream.com?
I did, no. No, but I bought that cookbook, Everything Tastes Better, with Sir Francis Bacon on it.
Yeah.
Seen it? Yeah. And so I'm on...
That's the... what we got time for. We have to a commercial break.
I know. Okay. I looked on the internet, and I found out that now that I'm at the midpoint of my life, I'm a crone. A crone. So I looked it up because I thought maybe I didn't know what it meant, and it meant exactly what I thought it meant.
What is it?
It's a derogatory term based on the French word carrion, which means dead flesh, any woman over 40.
Mm-hmm. Hey. Don't you owe that? It's the French. They've got special ways that we don't understand.
So You know, I called my friend Cindy Ratzlaff, and I told her, and it was interesting. She didn't want to be a crone either, and we decided we were going to be queen of our own life, because there's no celebration for a woman at the midpoint of her life. So we invented this crowning ceremony. And
a crowning ceremony, you say? What happens there to you?
Is
that part of it?
We're having our first ever virtual crowning party.
I thought crowning was something to do about having babies or something, isn't it?
I thought that was birthing babies.
Crowning, yeah, the baby.
Well, I think you can do it, but
yeah, okay. Right, all right, yeah.
Well, so anyway, if you come to our Facebook social media, you know, Queen of Your Own Life, for the next blah blah blah, you can get a crown.
Well, you got an actual crown with jewels on it.
Well, you get a crown
stuff?
On your avatar. Does Jeff have his own social media?
Nah.
No.
I don't think so. He's very odd tonight. He's been very weird. I don't know what's wrong with him. What's wrong with you, Jeff?
What you talking about, Willis?
Yeah. I don't know what that is. That's.
So we wrote a book.
Yeah. No, the book looks very nice, and Cindy looks well. I haven't seen her for a while.
She looks.
You both
well.
Look like you should be crowned queens of your own life.
We did, you know.
But what's the book about then? You can't just say, you get a free crown on every page. You know, what does it say?
That's the biggest virtual crowning party ever. But this book, it's not really self-help, it's self-love.
Self-love.
Yep, and it kind of, you know. Thank you. Here's the thing. Cindy and I have been friends for almost 35 years.
I know, and you always practiced self-love. I do know that. Because my trailer was right next to yours at the Drew Carey Show. I remember you would always practice self-love.
Wait a minute, your trailer was right next to mine.
That's exactly what I said.
Okay.
Do you enjoy bacon, by the way?
I have been known to snort down a piece of bacon or two.
Yeah. It's the new cocaine. Everyone in Hollywood's doing it.
I know.
Yeah.
I'm having a bacon party over the weekend. You're invited.
I'll be there with my bacon shoes.
I wanted to be just like you when I grow up, you know, so I had to write a book.
Yeah, no, it's nice that you wrote a book. I'm very happy for you you've written a book.
Thank you.
And who's this on the cover here?
That's, I don't know. I really don't.
Is that?
It's a woman in power.
In a corset. It's a woman in a corset.
With no hair under her arms.
No. But obviously not French, then.
Okay, let me ask you this. Somebody threw a birthday party for me when I turned 40, and it involved black balloons and a coffin-shaped cake and a basket with Depends.
Was that Bob?
Okay, it was.
It was Bob, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was Bob. But
we both know Bob, so don't worry about
that. But it has to be a better kind of party. There just has to be a better kind of party.
I thought Bob's parties for you were pretty good. That's a little unfair on Bob, isn't it?
No, I'm not saying anything about Bob, but let me ask you this. Did you ever come from a place of low self-esteem?
Why do you think I ended up in this dump? Yes!
Well, me too, and that's why.
I know that. No, I think it's good. I do, Kath. I think it's lovely.
Thank you.
And you've always been very good about that, about owning your own happiness and getting the life you deserve.
Yes, we're calling it the practice of happiness.
Yeah, it's hard to be happy. It's much easier to be miserable.
Well, did you know you're not born knowing how to be happy? Did you know that?
You're not?
You have to learn. You have to learn how to do it. And once you learn it,
during the crowning ceremony?
Yes. Well, the crowning ceremony involves you and a lot of friends, and we say a cake.
Right. Oh, well, cakes make me happy. Yeah, you make me happy with a cake.
I know.
I love a cake, man.
I love a cake.
I actually had some cake at the weekend.
You did? What kind?
Mrs. Ferguson made a banana cream pie.
Ooh, that's a pie.
Cake pie, come on.
That's like saying, you know, bacon carrots. Bacon carrots.
Yeah, it all goes down the same way, doesn't it? Anyway, that's not like saying bacon carrots. Pies, cakes and pies are very similar.
And
carrots and bacon are
bacon
worlds
and
apart.
And do you call your wife Mrs. Ferguson?
No, I was saying it that way. Yes, I do, actually, yes. And you assume it was my wife. It might easily have been Mrs. Ferguson from next door.
Oh, I thought maybe your mom or something.
That would be very difficult. Now, that would make the news.
Yeah.
From beyond the grave!
Okay, I know.
I've made you a pie! Not a cake! A pie!
Pie.
All right. Kenny, everybody.
Kenny and Prince. rendimos en el programa, señor Craig.
No tengo pantalones.
We gotta go. Good night, everybody. Good night. Good night.